noise gallery on the street. So it tells me the lights at the noise gallery are here.
For we two bedroom bags that we're here and ready to be here. We're quite different from all our galleries because of what we call the curatorial cutting. So the curatorial cutting essentially chooses what are for our exhibition program here. So it's quite different. It makes a really varied and different program rather than just having one versus overview of what the program should be. So we have six studio spaces which are very local. Not so much American artists, but for local artists, so that operates quite separately. And then we have an education program which operates at the moment in two strands. Those are the Boyle Art School, which is for mainly the 16 to 18 year olds who want to go on and study art at third level. But we've opened that up to get more mature students as well in order to support them in terms of third level education. And then we have Boyle Comics. And that's mainly for 6 to 12 year olds, and it's designed by Nick Brennan from the New York Dandy. They do the Boyle Comics with us for the last 8 years, which is great, and it's an alternative learning resource for children.
So, basically, you're saying that you're different because there's loads of galleries around town and you don't mind. So, what makes you kind of different from the rest of them?
So, you know, in the past 9 years, we have had 3 Turner Prize winners and we've had 4 Turner Prize nominees. So, we're really kind of aiming at quite a high level and library quality program. Mark Wallinger, who won the Turner Prize in 2009, has just joined our board of directors, which is brilliant. We have a show here last year. So, you know, we have shows that are on par with some of the major galleries, some of the shows that have been made for the Tate, we have brought to Derry. So it's a brilliant opportunity for the people of Derry who might not normally be able to travel to see other shows that we actually bring the artists here. And the artists also have an amazing experience here as well because Derry is such a unique urban place.
So this is our first time here tonight. So. The exhibition tonight has just launched, so it's very different from any exhibition I've seen in other art galleries. So tell us a wee bit about that exhibition, which is currently going on now for the next couple of weeks as well.
And as we have an exhibition every 5 to 6 weeks here, so we have on average about 6 to 7 exhibitions per year. An exhibition is only goes curated by a late performer who's one of our curators. It's a very humorous exhibition, which was also reflected in the artist's talk to me. She herself is also an extension of her work. It's really humorous view of the artist's biographies and artist's lives. So yeah, it's a really incredible exhibition, which is made up of various different components in it. So what you would have seen tonight is we have seen the paintings, we have seen the lines, we have seen the video installation, and video projection as well. So it's quite a mixture of mediums. And that's, you know, that's really essentially each different artist comes and they treat the space very, very differently. So it's really good to see that. And I think that's what's good about our program is that it's very, very diverse. And also some really, really serious exhibitions that engage with kind of major social and political issues. But also tonight was more of a humorous kind of side of things, which is great to see.
It is a great where the part is, so it's on Patrick Street, just down from where the old City Factory college used to be. It's sort of between Ellisville
Street. It's the main building on Patrick Street. It's the City Factory, which was Shirt Factory, which is the main industry in Derry. And we're in the basement, it's completely free. Each exhibition that we have is free, and each of the openings as well has an artist talk. And we feel that that's really important because sometimes people feel that art galleries are very kind of austere, difficult places to enter. And what you probably would have experienced tonight is the artist talk where people are free to ask questions about the work. And it's very much on a one-to-one basis that the artist is there on a very level playing field with the audience. They're not stood on the stage, they're there